There's a new website that's helping you go green by calculating the water footprint of your food. And as WDSU News reporter Ken Jones explains, you might be surprised at what uses the most water.
Water. It's one of our most precious resources, and it's one that many people take for granted.
I don't really pay attention.
At the farmer's market at San Francisco Civic Center Plaza, people flock to the stands looking for the perfect melon or juiciest strawberry. But often, most people don't think about how much water it takes to produce their produce. But the website waterfootprint.org thought a lot about it and did the calculations. For example, it takes 121 gallons of water to make one orange, a tomato, 47 gallons, but a peach or nectarine, 317 gallons of water.
I do think that footprinting can educate people about, wow, we do use water in everything we do. It really is an important resource, and it comes from somewhere other than my tap.
Heather Cooley studies water as a senior researcher at the Pacific Institute, and while she believes turning off your faucet when brushing your teeth or doing the dishes is a good thing, household water use accounts for only 6% of the water that we consume.
I think most people aren't aware of that, so water footprinting really gives them a way to think about those connections and to think about how they use water.
But thinking about water usage is hard for some people to swallow.
I think I'd still go for quality of the fruit over how much water was used. I don't think it would sway much. It depends, like, what kind of fruit I'd want.
And it's that attitude that makes Cooley want to get to the root of the issue, farms.
By reducing water use on our farms, in our businesses, it can reduce the water footprint in general for an individual, for a business, and for even a country or the globe.
But that takes money, something that's a lot more scarce than water, at least right now. On your side, Ken Jones, WDSU News.